up guys, tuffthumbz here. It's a special one tonight. Got some cool ass shit to show you. One of them, an original blade by Anonymous with handles by me. I'm not sure the availability of this thing yet, but I guess it's a prototype, but it is fucking gorgeous. But right here, I have this knife actually that I made like last year, just fucking around with an angle grinder and a leaf spring from a truck, and yeah, it was a lot bigger than this. I just fucking, I was just messing around with it today, and I made like a little, like crappy little fixed blade out of it. I don't know. I kind of like the design. I think I was going for like a meat cleaver, like just straight cut off. I think I'm gonna do that with it. Not this one, but when I get some more steel. I got some steel on the way. I got some N690 and some Vanex steel, I think. I got some really expensive shit too, for the folders. And so I did that, and I was messing around with the scrap piece, and I pulled a Warren Thomas here just as out of curiosity. I'm not gonna be doing stuff like this, but I may do something similar, but not, not Warren Thomas' style. I was just playing around with the scrap to see if it would work, and it's on there pretty good. It doesn't come off, so. But this thing's not heat-treated, so there's no way this is ever going to be anything but just a piece of crap. But, so I get into the first pimp job. It was a Manix 2. This is a redone. It's a little dirty because my hands are dirty, so it might look a little weird. But this one was sent back to me. It had the chameleon, the first one I did with the multiple scraps. It has jade scales with that are dyed gray. And I just put toxic with the jade over top of it, kind of like Gavco did. So it kind of has like a translucent, like frosty look on top of it. I may have to redo this one, so I might just take off the jade there because it's just not really staying too well. And but it'll look really good. I'll probably change it out, put a backspacer, or add something extra to it to make it a little bit more special. But it's pretty sweet. I mean, with just the toxic green and the dyed jade on there. So, oh shit, that's always good. Someone keeping count of how many times I drop knives in videos, because I tend to do it a lot. Just kidding. It's okay. But, that's that guy. And I had two Manix 2s. One had the Moon Glow and carbon fiber. The other one had Spyderco green and carbon fiber on it. Sent them back to Mark, and they're not there yet. So they were supposed to be delivered on the 1st, and they're not there. The post office doesn't know anything about it. So if you're a customer of mine and I sent you those, I mean, this is all I can think of because I double checked before I sent everything, but it says it's going to him, but if somehow one of you guys got it, let me know. But I highly, highly, highly doubt that. So, I'm just crossing my fingers on that. But sometimes I guess the hundreds of packages I've gotten, one or two getting lost ain't too bad. But I'll do my best to, anything that happens like that, guys, I do my best to make sure that you get. I don't have to, just because it's not technically my fault, but I will help you out as best as I can I'll definitely give you pimp jobs on something free, or a couple things, or whatever was done, and I try, I insure everything, but sometimes I don't. If I own the knife, I won't insure it, then I'll just give you mine, unless it's like really messed up or something. But so luckily that one's insured, so I'm just waiting on them to get back to me tomorrow about, they're looking into it. So anyway, just pointless. But next up is a knife that I have not seen pimped yet, and I'm pretty happy with the result. It is the DPX Hest folder. You can see the blade is stonewashed, looking hella good. Stonewashed, well, that's not me, but. And then on the other side, replacing the OD green, you got carbon fiber, reptilian. Looks damn good. Nice and centered. No blade play, excuse me. Nothing. No problems that I can see. This is the 2.0 Don't really notice much difference between mine and this one, but except there's no liners on the one side. But I do like the carbon fiber in the stonewash. Looks real good. That guy. And next up, now this one is very special, guys, and the glare from this thing is gonna kill my camera, I know it, so put your sunglasses on. But I showed this previously, it was very rough, it wasn't finished, and Anonymous finished it up. I don't know what he's calling it or anything like that, but it's gorgeous. I hope he does more of them. I know this might be just for his personal, just for him, but you know, playing around with designs and everything, seeing what he likes, and this one is just gorgeous, and I like the design a lot. And I originally saw it was really rough and just like a chunk of metal or steel that was just messed up, but here's the blade. You guys might remember this. Nice and convex, D2, like really high polish on that bitch. It's beautiful. This thing is razor fucking sharp too. Let's see if I can cut paper with it. I'm no good at this, guys. I'm not good at cutting paper or sharpening knives. Yeah, it's pretty damn sharp. So, man is good at sharpening. That's all I gotta say. So anyway, moving on to the rest of this, the reason I'm showing this guy. The scales I put on there are carbon fiber, reptilian, mosaic pins grooved in there with the pattern, and you got the lanyard tube yellow liners. Very nice grip on here, feels really good. It's a little cold out here, so anything I do near it's gonna make it, you know, you can see that. This gorgeous blade. I believe the reason for the shape is the clearance here. Focus. Clearance you get with your hands here. I'm not gonna rub my hands across it, but you get the idea. Let me see if I got something flat here. But I hope he starts selling these. I'd love to use one of these in the kitchen or, you know, out hunting or something, even though I've never hunted before, but yeah, I plan on doing it sometime soon. But it's a really cool shape, and I put my, what I'm going to do, be my signature handle, the little angle there, just cuts down there. The thing is just beautiful. This is one of the most beautiful knives, like, I've handled. It's just so nice, like the high polish and the carbon fiber. Yeah, Anonymous is gonna be making some shit that's gonna blow your mind. There's some nice thick ass D2 too. It's almost like a Persian scoop there. One day I'll get him on here talking about what his the reasoning for his shapes of his blades are, because he definitely has a lot of interesting ideas and interesting designs that I've seen. This is one of the more interesting ones that he had laying around, so I'm really glad he decided to go with this one. So I got this nice leather Spyderco rag here I got from Knife Center, which was a ripoff. But Jinx is beautiful. Yeah, look at this rag for $14. It's missing a leg or two or three on the Spyderco guy. I don't know, it's some crappy embroidering. Yeah, it works really well though. It's kind of like the Chris Reeves one. But you guys take that in, it's beautiful. And usually a blade like this, you know, if it's not properly polished, it would rust. This thing's been sitting in my garage, which would rust anything right away. And, you know, I have to keep some things in certain cases that you guys have here because they rust quick. But this guy is a D2, and usually D2 will rust. This guy, you know, you can see it's just flawless. But, yeah, guys, tonight, Modern Warfare 3, I will be going to pick that motherfucker up. Tough Thumbz Xbox, that's my name on there. Feel free to come join me and Alex Dietz and at Peace, hopefully, if he gets off his lazy ass and decides to be even lazier. Yeah, that's all I gotta say, guys. Hope you enjoyed this anonymous creation and the extremely loud music. That just feels so good in hand, too. But anyway, guys, have a great night. Peace.